YouTube, how are we? It's been a minute. Hope everyone's been good. And apologies, they're meant to be more videos, but I've had a bit of a stinker over the last few weeks. So I went to Egypt. I purchased a new camera. I was like, here we go, this is the start of something great. And I lost the camera day two, and then off the back of that, re-established my old camera. Battery's actually died twice, so it's rookie stuff, but it's a rookie channel, so as this progresses there will be less rookie mistakes, I'm sure of it. So this video is brought to you in Florida. I'm in Florida. It's been a mad year so far, to say the least. I've been to Dubai, Egypt, Florida, to England actually tomorrow whilst this is being filmed. So come out here obviously to support Joe. Today though, I wanted to get some footage in Mi40. It is my last session before I fly, and I'm a bit battered, so it's going to be just an arm session, maybe some delts, we'll see how we feel, and take you through it. But this little segment of the video is just talking about getting your head right before you go into your sessions. What sort of things are you doing? We might have a morning routine, we might have an evening routine, but have you actually established yourself a little bit of a pre-workout routine where, you know, we're really taking into consideration what we're about to do, why we're about to do it, and to prevent ourselves just going through our sessions and just going through the motions, especially if you're in like a growing phase or if you're in a off season or whatever label you want to give it. I think these are, if you've got yourself a sort of routine where you're fixating yourself and reminding yourself, the session feels a lot more valuable. I know it certainly does for me. And so while we're going through that, I think for me personally, I play a particular track, a Hans Zimmer track actually, and I imagine opposing routine that I'll do, and I'll imagine me winning the show. It's not to say like your goal has to be relative to competing. It could be imagining how you look in a certain time, whether it's the, like whether it's the summer, whether it's a holiday, and deeply visualizing how that's going to feel when you're looking like that. And you're going to feel so much more motivated going into the sessions when the goal is actually quite far away. And also just from a belief standpoint, I'm such a firm believer that you'll only ever achieve what you genuinely think that you can achieve. So if you are a competitor, whether you're an amateur or not, and you don't genuinely believe that you can win a show, or you don't believe you can place or get a first call out, you never will. And whether it's a physical effort or a subconscious effort, your efforts in the gym and your efforts outside of the gym will always correspond with what you believe in. So aim for the highest that you possibly can aim for in the bid that your actions will be more forward-coming. So for me, I have to visualize winning that show, winning that pro card. Nothing else is acceptable, okay? Whereas if I think to myself, oh, maybe I'll get a first call out, maybe I won't, I'm never going to win a show, and that's my personal opinion. And that can come over time. The genuine belief for your goal will come over time through consistent action and taking yourself to it. For example, if I believe that I'm going to win a show, I believe I get a second call out and I have a good workout, I'm going to believe it the same thing, right? Because the action is the same of a good workout. So you can install belief over time with confidence, which will come from consistent action. If I believe I'm going to win a show and I'm consistently hitting my macros, my meal plan or whatever, then I'm going to believe in it more and more as time goes on. So if you're just initially setting a goal, you know, you may not believe it deeply at first, but by telling yourself it, that's going to be 100% more beneficial than telling yourself that you can't do something. But that was the walk to the gym. Hope you enjoy the session. See what the gym's about. Just rock it up here. What's up, mate? Can I just pay for a guest pass, please?
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
change it on the frequency.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. So all this is glued on, and I don't have to move it around. I just like turn off the one channel, turn the other one on.
Yeah,
and
that's
right. And I'm just like, all right, now I can put this on.
And at least it's not a good care of this box.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that thing is so visible.
Yeah.
So there it is, simple arm session. You can put them in training split, or it's just like a nice way if you want to rest, if you want to get up for something. That does the whole business. So from Mi40, my last session here. Until next time. But for now, it's time to get some food. See what we got. Obviously Joe's still very deep in competing, so unfortunately this meal is without him while he's on 150 grams of carbs. So, oh, wrong side, not driving. Here we go. You good?
Hey. I got my second shot.
You, just then?
Yeah.
COVID-free?
COVID-free.
Yeah, let's go.
Wait.
So I hope you enjoyed the video today. More to come when I get back. For now we're gonna go chill out. Unfortunately Tom is cramping up big time post leg session. Nearly there bro. Like, subscribe, and catch you on the next one.
Ah, oh, you're right.